Mr Speaker, research and development, the adoption of digital technology and affordable and reliable energy will be critical to Australia's future economic prosperity. In this budget, we are providing $2 billion in additional research and development incentives, removing the cap on refunds, lifting the rate and rewarding those businesses that invest the most. We're also providing $459 million in additional funding for the CSIRO, $1 billion for new research funding for our universities, backing our best and brightest minds whose ideas will help drive our recovery, and $1.9 billion in new funding as part of our energy plan to support low emissions and renewable technologies, helping to lower emissions and address climate change. We're also helping to unlock five key gas basins, starting with the Beetaloo Basin in the Northern Territory and the North Bowen and Galilee Basins in Queensland. More gas at lower prices will support more jobs in Australia's manufacturing sector. Mr Speaker, rebuilding our economy includes building more roads, more rail and more bridges. In this budget, we will expand our 10-year infrastructure pipeline, which is already supporting 100,000 jobs across work sites today. Together, what we have announced since the start of this crisis, measures in this budget will see $14 billion in new and accelerated infrastructure projects support a further 40,000 jobs. This will boost productivity and deliver benefits to Australians. This budget will fund major projects across each state, the Singleton bypass and Bolivia Hill upgrade in New South Wales, the upgrade of the Shepparton and Warrnambool rail lines in Victoria, the Coomera connector in Queensland, the Wheatbelt secondary freight network in Western Australia, the main South Road duplication in South Australia, the Tasman Bridge upgrade in Tasmania, the Carpentaria Highway upgrades in the Northern Territory, and the Molongalo River Bridge in the ACT. These and many other projects we are funding will set Australia up for the future, because we know that building more infrastructure now means building and creating more jobs. So tonight, we're also announcing $2 billion investment in road safety upgrades to save Australian lives. Yeah. Funding for these shovel-ready projects will be provided on a use-it-or-lose-it basis. If a state drags its feet, another state will get the money. Yeah. We need works to start, not stall. We're also expanding the local roads and community infrastructure program, investing an additional $1 billion to support local council immediate upgrades of local roads, footpaths and street lighting. These investments in our local communities will support local jobs.